Hey everyone, my name is Anna and I work with SAS as a technical trainer. And today in this tutorial, I'm going to be covering how to convert your data. So how to go from character to numeric, and then also numeric to character. Because oftentimes we get data from a lot of sources, it comes to us as character, and it's not something we really want to work with in that format, so we have to do the conversion. So to get started, I'm just going to jump over to SAS. To get us started, I have some fake data. This is called, actually we'll start with this one, race, and it's just some race data for some road races. These aren't real, but ones that I've decided to sign up and run for this fall winter. So you can see we have the race name, we have a race date, and then we have the distance. For some reason I decided to run a half marathon first, so that should be fun. But we want to take this race date column, and I personally would like to create a training program, figure out how I should run, when I should run, and when my races are coming up. So I need to take this race date column that's currently character and create a numeric version of it. So I'm going to do that in SAS with the data step. So that starts with data, and I'm going to just create a new data set. You don't have to, you can create these columns in the original data set. I'm going to create a new one. So I'm going to call it race new. We're pulling from our race data. And then I'm going to call this new column date, and I'm going to use the input function. The input function allows us to take a column or variable and then use an informat to tell SAS how to read that data, and then it creates a new column that's numeric. So we're going to take this character column race underscore date, and then use an informat, tell SAS how to read this data in, how this data is structured, and create date, which will be a numeric column. Let's just go look at the data one more time. If we look at race underscore date, it's written with a 2-digit day, a 3-character month, and then a 4-digit year. And it's all written really consistently, which is nice for us. So we're gonna use the informat that corresponds to that, which is date 9. So we'll specify here date 9 dot, and that in format will just say, hey, SAS, this is how our data is structured. This is how you're going to need to read it in. The 9 corresponds to the width. So let's go ahead and run this, see what happens. Awesome, we got a data set. That's good. So we have our race name, we have our race date. That's the original character column. We have our distance, and then we have this new date column here. And looking at this data set, there's a couple things I want to fix. First, let's go ahead and get rid of this character race date. It's not really important, not useful. Second, I want to call date race underscore date. I want to rename it. And then if you look at these dates, they are SAS dates. They're stored as the number of days since January 1st, 1960. However, this isn't really easy for us to read. I personally don't know how many days it's been since January 1st, 1960. So we should probably apply a format, make it easy for us to read. So let's do all those things. First thing is our rename. So I'm using a rename dataset option, and I'm going to go ahead and just rename that old column so that we know it's the old one. We want to get it out of here. Let's call it old. And in our input, we'll just say old, so we know that's the old date. Now we can call date race underscore date like we had it originally. We can write drop. We're putting a drop statement here, and we're dropping old. And then the last thing we want to format. So race date, our new numeric column, I'm going to apply a format so it's easy to read. MMDDYY10 dot. So that is a SAS date format, 10 units long, and it's going to display our date in an easy to read fashion. So if we run this, we get our output data set. So we have our race name, we have our distance, and now I have a race date that is numeric. I can order by it, and I can now start prepping for my half marathon. All right, so that is how you go from character to numeric. Now, to go from numeric to character, pretty simple, very similar concept. I do have some new data to work with to see this. So I'm gonna open up NC data. If you see this SAS help library down here, this is actually coming from the zip codes data set that's in that library. So I just made a subset of it. It's got our state code for North Carolina. It has a county value, and then it has an area code, so for phone numbers. And I want to create a little NC tag where I concatenate the state code followed by the county followed by the area code. Now, this county, I want them to all be the same amount, same length. So I want them all to be 3 units long. And if you notice, it's got a 1 here. And then if we scroll down, this one's 101. I want to add some leading zeros to these 1-digit and 2-digit counties. So that's a lot to do. Let's go to SAS to get it done. All right, I'm going to start a data step. I'm going to create a new data set, NC ID. I'm pulling from the NC data set. And then let's create our 2 character columns. So you can rely on SAS to do conversion, but I would never recommend it. It's always good to explicitly do the conversion yourself. So I'm going to do area underscore C and convert that one to a character column. Now, instead of the input function, I'm going to use the put function. Input, we specify a source and a format. The format needs to correspond to the source data type. So here we're taking numeric. We need to use a numeric format. And then we'll create a character column. So this will be area code. And then area code is just 3 units across, very simple. So we'll use 3 dot as our format. For that county character column, I'm again going to use the put function. We're converting county. And then remember, I wanted those leading zeros. That's where the Z3 format comes into play. So the 3 just corresponds to the width. I want it to be 3 units long. The Z is the format itself. So we're saying, all right, 3 units long, add leading zeros when necessary. So this is going to create these 2 character columns, area underscore C and county underscore C. So let's go ahead and run this, check it out. All right, so in our output data set, I'll scroll in a little. We have these old ones, county and area code, that were numeric, and now we have these 2 character columns. So we can concatenate them together, create a nice little tag for different parts of North Carolina. So I'm gonna call that NC tag. I'm gonna use the catx function. So we're getting a little more info than just conversion of character and numeric data. We're gonna use a concatenating function here. And the catx function allows us to specify a delimiter that we want in between the columns that we're going to concatenate. So the delimiter we're going to use is an underscore. We specify that first, and then we specify the columns we're going to concatenate. So we're going to concatenate state code, followed by county underscore C, our character county code, and then area underscore C. So that's going to concatenate these 3 columns together with underscores in between. Last thing I'm going to do, I'm just going to go ahead and drop these 2 columns that we're creating. We really only needed them for creating this NC tag, so we can go ahead and get rid of them here. They are still available for processing. We'll be able to create NC underscore tag, but they won't be in our final data set. So let's run this. And fabulous. We've got our state code, county, and area code, and then we have this awesome NC tag that we needed to create. So that allowed us to take these 2 numeric columns, create character columns, and then concatenate to create this NC tag. All right, so that's how you go from character to numeric or numeric to character. Feel free to subscribe to SAS users above for more SAS tips and tricks. Comment below if you have any questions, and happy programming. Thanks, guys.